In order to design your new kitchen, you first need to sit down and decide two things. Why you will need to know how much room you have to put your kitchen in, and you'll also need to know what you want to be able to do in your kitchen. If you're looking for a lot of food preparation area, for example, you'll want a different kitchen layout than somebody who is trying to find a place to fit lots of food and cooking utensil storage. Once you've decided on the basic layout for your kitchen, then you'll need to think of what appliances you're going to put in there. Why you'll need to make sure that there is enough room in your kitchen for the refrigerator and oven Y, and probably a dishwasher as well. Why therefore, once you have a general idea of where you want to put your appliances, you should decide exactly which ones will be put in. Then, once you have the measurements for those appliances, you'll be able to decide how to finalize the rest of your kitchen design. Why some things that you should consider regarding the design of your new kitchen are how difficult it will be to install or repair the appliances that you have in your kitchen. Why, if you make it difficult to reach the back of your refrigerator, then you'll have a hard time getting back there if it ever needs to be repaired. Additionally, you should avoid having gaps between counters in areas where you will be cooking or washing dishes often. Why the reason for this is that gaps allow food or water to fall down in hard to reach places. Why, which means that when you finally do get to that part of the floor, it will be even messier than you would have expected. There are two main things that you should think about using while you're designing your kitchen. Why one thing is always a good step. Why that is just using a pencil and paper to draw out what you want to put in it. Why however, if you do not trust your artistic skills, you can also find online programs that will help you make a great kitchen design.